Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 30 crew has been awake since midnight Central Time, and they are now more than halfway through their day and coming to the end of a typically busy week on board the space station. Over the past week, we've seen the crew work on a number of different scientific experiments. One of them that's been a recurring activity this week is the SLICE experiment, or the Structure and Liftoff and Combustion Experiment, which aims to improve the design and efficiency of combustion technologies, as well as computer models of flames, by taking advantage of the station where gravity doesn't complicate a flame's behavior. This video was recorded on Monday of Flight Engineer Don Pettit working on that activity. He also spent time on it yesterday, and we'll revisit it again next Monday. Predicting the shape and temperature of burning gases is complicated on Earth by the buoyancy effect, so observations of the temperature and shape of flames and microgravity will help scientists and engineers improve the design and efficiency of combustion technology, as well as computer models of flames. Another experiment we saw come up several times this week was the capillary flow experiment. Commander Dan Burbank was working on that one just yesterday, and it looks at how liquids behave in microgravity, as well as how we might be able to control their behavior through the designs of the containers the liquids are stored in. That will help increase confidence in the design systems used in space that involve liquids. And the BCAT-6 experiment was another popular experiment this week. Pettit performed some work with it. Its name stands for the Binary Colloidal Alloy Test. Over the course of the experiment, scientists on the ground study how liquids and gases that the astronauts have mixed up for them separate and form structures in microgravity over time. For the past several days, Pettit has been working to perform checkouts on a combustion chamber inside the Kibo laboratory. He checked out the LAN and USB cables for that facility, as well as the power source and its video capability. He actually wrapped up those checkouts yesterday, and today Pettit was scheduled to restow the facility back inside the racks of the Kibo laboratory. You can see the hole that it goes in there, and it's going to be ready to go now when needed. Although it's not an experiment, a major activity that Commander Burbank wrapped up this week was the EPIC upgrade of the station's computers. EPIC stands for Enhanced Processor and Integrated Communications, and it describes a version of computer processor card that was installed on seven of the station's computers over the past couple months to better enable them to handle all the experiments and other work that's now going on board the space station these days. Burbank installed the last two of those seven processor cards on Tuesday and Wednesday, which brings an end to this phase of the upgrade. Next phase won't occur for a while yet, and will involve upgrading computers on the exterior of the space station. Also, the station is flying a little higher now than it was last week. On Wednesday morning, the Zvezda service module's engines were fired for 1 minute and 16 seconds, raising the station to a 254 by 232 mile orbit, and putting it in place for an upcoming string of dockings and undockings that's going to take place over the next several months. In addition to all that, today the crew is working on a few different activities. Don Pettit has been spent a good portion of his day with the Express Rack 4 and the Destiny Laboratory. Express racks are the structures that are closet-sized and used to house many of the smaller experiments that aren't big enough for an entire rack to themselves. Today Pettit was doing a change out of a failed rack interface control on the Express Rack 4. And of course, water recovery systems is an ongoing work. Kuiper's has been working with that on and off throughout the week and on its regularly scheduled maintenance. And if you're interested in finding out more about why it's important to keep the plumbing going on space, you might check out Don Pettit's latest blog, which can be found at blogs.nasa.gov. That's what's been going on in space this week, and this is Mission Control Houston.